Street Talk came from, I was in a band with Craig Cramp years ago, and that was going to be the name of our band. And accidentally, unfortunately, a situation happened. One of our members got killed in a car accident. So after that happened, we disbanded, of course. And the name Street Talk has still been floating around, you know. So it just was appropriate, since I got back together with Craig one more time, that we would just call the album Street Talk. Craig Cramp is just a really good friend of mine who helped me find a lot of musicians that we used to work with, or I had never worked with before, but he had been working with. And he also is a very good songwriter, and we wrote on the earlier albums together. And so we wrote on this album, Street Talk, and he did help me find a lot of musicians, like I said, that I wanted to work with. People like Bill Como and Dwayne Hitchings. And then other musicians I found through people like Randy Goodrum, I found through Andy Newmark, and the drummer, Larry London, I found through Randy. It was like one from another, you know. One thing I caught myself as being a producer of my own album, I wanted to make sure that the tunes were as good as a producer should make sure they are. And that was that hat I was wearing. And so there were times where I wasn't really satisfied with maybe a lyrical content that I had worked up to that point. So I would bring in Randy Goodrum. I went for a whole different thing entirely. I went for a different production sound. I went for a different band sound, different vocal register. Things that I used to do an awful lot before I joined the group Journey. I came from R&B. A lot of my friends have called me, used to be in bands with me years ago, and said, well, this album sounds more like you or the Steve Perry I used to work with than anything I've ever heard you do. So it does have a little bit of that old flavor that I used to work with all the time. And I personally really was a Sam Cooke fan, so I wanted to mention Sam. And I was a very heavy Jimi Hendrix fan. Still am. I like his music. And you hear a lot of that influence in music today. There's so many situations that can come from a love situation, or a possibility of one, or the loss of one, or a problem with one, or any number of situations that there's a lot of to write about. It's fun because you're writing little mini movies, and they are little mini vignette things, and they have a plot, they have a beginning, they have an end. Well, it was hard, first of all, finding a director that wanted to work with an artist. Most directors come in and the first thing they want to do is say, I got this great idea. I got some torches, I got a cave, I got some smoke, you're going to love it. I got these chicks in leather, they all got dog collars on, you're going to love it, you know. Well, I mean, that might fit for some things, you know. I'm not denouncing it, that it doesn't work for certain types of groups and certain music, but it just didn't have no place in the song, Oh Sherry. I did finally find a director, Jack Cole, who was willing to work with me on some conceptual ideas of the video. So we all sat on the deck, worked up the idea, got to the point where we were trying to put across that feeling. You know, some director comes across with an idea that is a good idea, but it's a little bit crazy for the song.
This is ridiculous. I can't.
Damn it, do Apple take six.
I look at video, this medium of video, like the movie, and I look at the song that usually it has to help as the book. And every book is better than a movie, usually. You'll always hear that. It seems like the song is always better than a video, because it's usually the first thing, usually these days, the first thing you will hear is the song. But that's even changing because of the advent of video success groups versus radio success groups. But there's a mystique to music in a radio or record form that lets each person, I think, interpret or hear or see in their mind's eye what it means to them. And I think it's really important not to destroy that. Underneath it all, I'm just a person. I'm just a guy that likes to sing an awful lot and likes to write music and likes to produce. I don't worry about looking good. Everybody, oh, gee, I don't know. I like pasta and I like beer and I like wine. I don't know. I'm not as neurotic about it.